Well, it's not very often that I get to speak with an honorary member of the Dark Empire, especially one who, on a personal level, is very influential in my aspirations in voiceover artwork, so to speak. I'm sort of a voiceover artist in my own right, I guess. I kind of dabble in it. But when I get to speak to somebody that does it for a living, as their main profession, I'm always in awe, especially when it's somebody that I highly admire. And I highly admire our guest this time around. He's done a lot of work in voiceover, but as a Star Wars fan, you might identify with him most as the voice of Captain Tarkin in the Clone Wars animated series. He's Steven Stanton. Welcome to Dark Empire Radio, Mr. Stanton. How are you?
Hi, Joe. I'm fine. Thanks for that wonderful introduction. That was very kind of you to say all those nice things about me.
Oh, well, it's from the heart, you know. I suppose if the Sith have a heart, I wouldn't know these things, now would I?
You've proven yourself to have a heart pretty well so far from the dealings that I've had with you.
Oh yeah, that's my heart, the one that ticks. One works.
Don't give away anything else.
Okay.
You're a nice guy.
Oh, well, thank you. Yeah, Han said that too. He said I'm a nice man, and look what it got him. Yeah, a bunch of time in carbonite. Yeah. You mentioned Mel Blanc was one of your fellow inspirations as well, but what would you say really, really got your fire burning for voiceover as a career? And about how old were you when you considered that choice as something that you wanted to do for a living?
Well, I think actually it probably was Mel Blanc that got me really interested in it. When I, you know, back when I was growing up, we used to have the Saturday morning cartoons, which are really kind of a thing of the past right now. But, you know, as a kid, you woke up Saturday morning and, you know, starting at around 7 a.m., you had nonstop animation, you know, until about a little after lunchtime, you know, midday. And I would watch, you know, as many things as I could, you know, tune into one right after the other. And then once I started, like, realizing, you know, looking at credits and things, and they go by really quick on Saturday morning, that I started seeing the same names, you know, people like Mel Blanc and Dawes Butler and, you know, all the Hanna-Barbera crew. And I realized, wow, it's just like a few people doing like almost all of this stuff.